Thank you, sir. I don't normally jump in first, but I am this time, if you guys would allow me. I've given out some information that I was planning on recommending. A while ago, we were discussing using funds that had built up in the cultural account to move to capital projects and maybe some other projects such as lifeguards. So I know we're going to talk about this in more of an extent next meeting, because Commissioner still brought up wanting to use money for lifeguards. Great idea. So on this, last time I told you guys I'm not going to vote for any more of the cultural funds. I don't like what we're doing with them. I don't think we have a good flow with what we're doing. They're the same things over and over. And you know, the world I live in, people vote with their money. And if they don't show up by now voting to keep something, it might mean they don't really care about it enough to keep it. So that's part of my heartburn too. And I've been on this board for a while. I mean, at first I was learning it, and then there was a couple times that it was doubled because they had extra funds and Commissioner Tobiah caught it. And it's just not, it's just taxpayer dollars. We have to be good stewards of it. So I'm looking for the best return on investment as far as these funds. So I've been talking to the county attorney a little bit. At the end of this year, there's going to be $1.4 million in this account. And what we can do is move this over to the marketing dollars. We're allowed to do that. We have to use up to 10% of the first two pennies, but it doesn't mean we have to do it. So we can move it right into marketing. And with this, the marketing funds, I believe we're going to get a better definition from the county attorney. But as of right now, he thinks that it's doable, that we can use that to pay for the lifeguards that we need to pay for. If people are not surviving our beaches, it's going to clobber our tourism. And so, Commissioner Steele, I just kind of helped find us some money here. And so let's say that we have a couple of projects that are fairly good. I think it's better that they go and get reimbursed out of the marketing funds for marketing they do outside of Brevard County if we're truly trying to get heads in beds. So if there's some good projects and that needs to help to increase the size of the project, then we've just kind of taken care of maybe something good going on, like air shows, I don't know, market it outside. I feel a lot better. Get them a reimbursement on marketing that they do. So this is my ideas, guys. I think they're good ones, but just so you know, I already told y'all last time we did this, I'm not going to vote for anything else that we do in the cultural funds, because I'm just not comfortable with them. So that's where I'm at right now. But this is a good solution here, and it saves us a lot of money, and then it takes care of the lifeguard situation. Commissioner Tobiah won.
Mr. Chairman? Are you handling this, or Mr. Tobiah, Commissioner Tobiah? Are you the chair now?
No.
No, I just, oh, you, he you just put his it? Light on some.
Oh,
him.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'd gone in a, thank you, Madam Chair, I'd gone in a much more specific route to focus this in on lifeguards. I like the, I'd like the way Commissioner Steele had gone on this and finding a way to do it. However, your plan is better because it offers more leeway. So you have my full support on this, and I also want to thank Commissioner Steele for putting that out there, because I think this is a plan that could not only help the county but help the cities as well, because this is collected within the municipalities as well. And I didn't think there was an alley for that, and you know, I was absolutely wrong. So Madam Chair, I certainly will be supporting your proposal. It's better than mine, and I want to thank you for your leadership, as well as Commissioner Steele for bringing up the idea that we spend resources to fund lifeguards. So,
Madam Chairperson,
you have pushed the button.
Oh, got to push my buttons. My buttons have been pushed all night.
Are you trying to push your button?
I already, yes.
Go ahead.
Down. Okay. All right. Madam Chair, are you recognizing me? Or?
I have Commissioner Feltner right now.
Okay. That'll work.
And then I got to teach you guys these buttons. Yeah. Then Commissioner Goodson and Commissioner Steele.
Thank you.
We're good?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay.
Okay.
You want me to go, or who's going?
I'm him go.
Do it real quick.
I was thinking the same thing this over the last week. I appreciate Commissioner Steele bringing this back to this, I think, this important issue. So my understanding is that if we advertise the, or we market the beach and lifeguard services, then we can use TDT for paying for lifeguards. I'd like possibly Morris to give us clarification on that real quick, and then I have a follow-up.
I'm bringing back the requested report at your meeting on the 22nd, but initially, yes, you're allowed to use the marketing portion of the funds. You're allowed to expend those on activities, services, venues, or events, as long as the venue, service, activity, or event has as one of its main purposes the attraction of tourists, as evidenced by the promotion of the activity, service, or venue, beach safety, lifeguards, things of that nature, to attract tourists, and to prevent the perception that this is a dangerous place to come. It can qualify as long as they are then promoted and marketed to draw tourism.
So in this motion that Commissioner Pritchett has.
We might wait till the next meeting. I don't know. I'm ready to do it now. But
I'm ready to rock and roll.
Okay. No, we might do it tonight.
Okay. So a portion of this will be spent marketing the beach and lifeguard services. And then what portion of that are we able to use for the lifeguards?
I haven't talked dollars because I need direction from the board, so I haven't talked figures with Peter and what this would mean. But the idea is you would allocate a certain amount of funding to the service, and then you would use some marketing funding to advertise and promote that the existence of that service.
You can ask Frank how much lifeguards cost.
Can we get clarification? I'm ready to vote this way tonight too. If we can just clearly say that of this amount, so much is going to have to go to marketing our beaches and lifeguard services, and then the other portion we can spend on the lifeguards.
Yeah, depending on what the board direction is, I think you can do up to the full amount going to the lifeguard services, as long as in the marketing and the dollars that are currently allocated, you're doing a sufficient amount, and that's what we would have to look at of advertising that markets the beaches and those lifeguard services. So it could even be tweaks of some of the marketing that's currently ongoing, and then you could use all those funds if that's what the board chose to do.
Frank's exactly right. You could even go beyond that, but you could certainly use whatever you're transferring over, and then you wouldn't be impacting the marketing that you're already doing.
Can I ask a follow-up?
Yeah.
Would any TDT then be available for lifeguards in the municipalities, or is this only unincorporated Brevard potentially?
All right, a little bit of a spoiler. I know the direction for the report was do this in unincorporated, but the Florida Constitution says that when you collect a countywide tax, you can't use it exclusively for the benefit of the unincorporated. So you would necessarily have to spend some of that in the locations and municipalities. You have discretion in terms of don't spend it where it's not needed, but you have a report that's identified some localities and municipalities where you need lifeguards. So if you fund lifeguard services with TDT, that's going to include funding lifeguard services within municipalities as well, or else you can't do it. I'll say that now.
We can determine the amount to each area, though, correct?
You can, as long as it's not arbitrary, as long as it's based on need and things like that, sure. Okay.
Mr. Goodson?
Yes, thank you, Madam
and
Chair.
Mr. Steele?
I would like to consider a motion to table this till the staff comes back and tells us how much money, tells us if the cities are going to be responsible for any kick-in. And that way, because we just got through a long session here of people saying we vote without knowing what we're voting on. So I'd like to make a motion, Madam Chair, that we table this until we have an understanding of how much money and where is it going.
Okay, I've got the data already, so that would have to be
a quick vote if you're going to throw it on the table tonight, Madam Chair, and expect me to vote on it.
You're correct, sir. My main vote right now is I'm not going to spend the money in cultural. I already told you guys that a couple months ago. So I think it needs to be moved somewhere that's a little bit more responsible with the return on investment. Mr. Steele, you are up, though. I'm going to let you speak here, and then I got some cards we got to go through.
Well, First of all, I had a motion, but this, the Madam Chairperson, this is much better than I could imagine.
You're so kind.
My question would be, what do we do with the people? Do they come back in? I know that you're not interested in doing any cultural grants, and if I thought I could have gotten away with that early on, I would have eliminated the cultural grants totally myself. So I get that. But the bottom line is that we've kind of let these people know or thought that they were going to potentially get out of because of the recommendation of the TDC, some monies. Now, what would they do? Would they be able to come in and ask for some of these monies?
My thought on that is you would go to the marketing then, and they could get reimbursed for marketing if it's marketing out of Brevard County.
Okay, so I get it.
So that was my thought of giving some help there, some love, if we're truly doing the heads in beds.
Well, and going to Commissioner Goodson's proposal on tabling it, I appreciate that. But just to let you know, we have I've sat down with the county attorney, the county manager, and a variety of other people in regards to being able to get to this particular point. The amount is very simple. It's right there, $1,440,000. The county attorney tonight said that we can use as much of it as we want, as long as we are fair to the cities, and we can do some of it for marketing and some of it for the actual lifeguards itself. I mean, I can see the advertising is, you know, we've got your back. Come to Brevard County where you're safe. And I can just see it. And I said before that Ron Johns has offered to potentially contribute some additional money to us for the Drown Zero program. So lots of good things can happen with this. And I would love to walk away from here tonight with this proposal accepted and approved. I don't know what good it would be to table it, because what you're really talking about is $1,440,000, and that's the basis for the number. We had the county attorney just tell us we can use the funds. I don't know why we would delay it.
Okay, Commissioner Tobias, I have cards. Do you want to comment right now, or you want to go through cards?
For just 1 minute.
Please.
I think we're really very close here. Commissioner Goodson's suggestion to the table is not unwise, but moving it over to the marketing portion doesn't signify we're providing X in marketing and Y in lifeguards. So I think it's very similar, and I think we're going to end up in the same place. My numbers are a little bit different. We're expected to collect $1.08 million in new revenue from these two pennies, or 10% of two pennies. There's also $962,000 in carry forward. So we're looking actually at a little over $2 million. If we looked at the lifeguard study that we had before, including the capital, we were at about 3.4 in total. So we're looking at somewhere in the neighborhood of 30% cost. Now, initially, 30% coverage. So initially, you know, I wasn't too interested in helping cover the cost of the municipalities, but unfortunately, Morris over there screwed that idea up, or the Florida Constitution screwed that idea up, wisely so. I think we should spread the wealth. This would allow us to do that. So when we ask for pay-in, we could help provide some of that. So Commissioner Goodson, I agree with you that I don't want to vote on the specifics of which goes to marketing and which goes to lifeguards right now. And that's what actually my motion did. And that's why I said Commissioner Pritchett's is much wiser, because we're just putting it in that bucket. And the report that we get back from Morris in 2 weeks, we can help determine how much goes in one and how much goes in there. We may even punt it to the TDC to ask what their opinion is and make a decision. But I wouldn't vote for individually, but putting in that bucket, again, I think is a very wise idea. So, again, I think tabling and putting it there are very similar.
Okay.
Would it be cleaner if we did a motion to deny the cultural grants and come back? Because I think we have a question of a motion that's still out there, so I just want to bring that back to...
Just move it to the marketing portion, and then we as a commission need to come back and maybe give some recommendations to the TDC, and they need to give it to us how to divvy up those funds. But again, if there's worthy culturals, they can always apply for help with reimbursement for marketing if it's bringing heads in beds. But I would like to, if we've got the votes, to just go ahead and deny the cultural and move that money into the marketing, and then we come back and we decide how to use the marketing funds for lifeguards and for marketing and...
Just a quick clarification.
That would be my preference, but I spent a lot of time on it.
I think we're close.
Okay.
So is that the 1.7 or the 1.44?
I think there's 900. County manager, you gave me exact numbers right now of what we're doing.
I was going from your sheet.
That's the exact numbers by the time we get at the end of the year. That's how much will be in there. But there's a $900,000 amount in there right now, correct?
That's the anticipated cash carry forward at the beginning of the year. If you added the $530,000 that was in this agenda item, you would add that to the $900,000, so you would be at about $1.44 million.
Okay. Commissioner Tobias, did you have something different with that, sir?
No, Madam Chair. Since you had the gavel, I was just going to make the motion.
Okay.
So I move to deny the 2023-2024 Cultural Support Grant Program recommendations and direct staff to redirect the funds into the marketing budget.
Question, Madam Chair. May I have a question?
Certainly, sir.
Before we vote, can I ask Morris? Morris, will this be looked at like by Harrietta Moore Foundation as discriminatory by canceling all these that have already been vetted?
It's not discriminatory because you're not singling anyone out. You're canceling or you're not granting any of the grant awards. So I'd be hard pressed to find any basis to charge discrimination on them.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Okay, I have a motion. Do I have a second or more discussion?
Second.
Second by Commissioner Steele. Did you want to say something?
No.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Passes 5-0, and we have a lot of work to do moving forward, trying to really bring in the heads and beds for the county for these types of funds. Ms. Young, thank you for all your work on the TDC. You are a champion out there working so hard and helping the community get better projects out. I'd appreciate you, ma'am.
Take a bite.